of the show today. Bill began his career as an officer in the United States Army, learning the benefits of discipline, planning, and the need for rapid response. After his military career, he became a senior executive with technology companies. Today, Bill is a franchise advisor and consultant. In addition, he is the host of Reinventing Your Future on the Better You Network, and he is the co-founder of VetBuds. VetBuds is a nonprofit group where the members share a common bond of military service and the desire to provide assistance to veterans. Bill, thank you for being on the show today.
Thank you for having me. It's a pleasure to be here.
Thank you, Bill. So, Bill, how does Axon find the right franchise business for your clients?
Well, it's a process. I mean, about to celebrate my 9th anniversary, which is surprising in the industry. You know, I've learned over that time that there's a process, and it's really, you know, learning about the individual and what they're trying to achieve long range. You know, people sometimes come to me and say, oh, I really like ice cream, and I talk them out of that. And really focus on what they're trying to achieve for a lifestyle and their goals, that you know, what they want their life to look like.
Right.
So it's learning a lot about the individual, the good, the bad, and strengths and skills, and you know, what they like to do. And we match up a business then. Well, I wish I were. One of the great things I think about what we do in our business is that I can provide these services for people at absolutely no cost. I get paid like a realtor gets paid when a deal gets done by the seller. You know, so the franchise companies really look to us to bring them qualified people, interested people, motivated candidates that fit their profile. And they compensate us when the deal gets closed. So a client can walk through the front door all by themselves of a franchise, and they can come through me or someone like me, and they will pay the exact same fee. So it's a great way to take advantage of someone's experience.
Yeah.
Well, we know the industry, okay, mm-hmm. And the people who work on their own tend to look at maybe different things, and we concentrate, you know, on what they're really good at and what they're trying to achieve, and match up 3 or 4 businesses like that, and you know, so we make them aware of franchises that they probably would never look at or find on their own. Mm-hmm. In fact, you know, I can say that probably 90% of the people I've worked with end up in something they would never have picked out of the catalog, because they think, oh, there's a nice place for a hamburger place, or, you know, and of course we steer away from the food concepts, but it just, you know, really concentrate on long range versus mm-hmm. short term. You know, the franchise companies have a profile, including in that profile is the financial information. Mm-hmm. So people really need to have some capital investment. You know, we like to say, you know, liquid assets, 75 to 100,000, opens up a lot of doors. You know, which, you know, that's a lot of money, mm-hmm. but maybe a whole lot less than people think. You know, so I mean, they think about, you know, bigger investment, $500,000 or something like that. There's just many, many choices that people can get into for much less than that.
Yeah. That's good to hear. And can you help with financing?
Not directly, but we do have some options that we can steer people to and work through. And a lot of the franchise companies themselves have like third-party partners that they might be able to help them with. So we can give them some advice and some steering but we can't do it directly.
What are some of the franchises
kind of a quick question? Well, I took that a lot. And my franchise, I guess I'm a bit of a smart aleck, because I usually say I don't know and I don't care, because if it doesn't fit the individual, it doesn't matter. And I coach people to look at trends and not fads. sometimes the hot things are fans, and they wear out very quickly, 2 or 3, 4 years. So I'd rather look for something that is a trend. So services are always very strong. Mm-hmm. You see the baby boomer generation, nobody around this interview, mm-hmm. of course, but you know, but a lot of needs, a lot of changes. You know, retirement, the whole idea of retirement is changing. So, you know, what services do people need and are going to be strong in the future?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's a good question.
Yeah, I think that's true. Very important. So does that work with all kinds of franchises, and if not, are my choices kind of limited?
Well, you can say that. On the other hand, again, we've been in the industry for quite a while, and we know who the strong players are, and we cover the gamut. I mean, there's 3,000 or 4,000 different franchises day by day, you know, and we work with about 100 different ones that pretty well cover the gamut of product or services that people would be interested in. So, you know, we've worked with them, we've proven, you know, we look at them quite often and review and make sure that we're putting our clients into a winning situation.
Yeah, good. Yeah.
Well, first of all, franchises are very highly regulated by the Federal Trade Commission. So they have to provide they all have to provide a base of information, and using that information you can evaluate, you know, what your total investment's going to be, what the performance might be. You can go through the process of validation, and you have the right, and we encourage people to talk to as many current owners in that brand that you can, and ask them about their experience, about the training, about the support, you know. Would they do it again? Are they making the kind of money they want to make? That's where the real value is that coaching them through that process.
Yeah, that's good.
Right.
And so what are some of the misconceptions about franchising?
Well, first of all, you know, that everything is related to food. You know, it's really only a small segment of the industry. It's certainly a big one. It's a small percentage overall of the brand. So, but it's certainly most recognized. But there's so many concepts out there. I mean, document destruction, junk hauling, you know, junk removal, disaster recovery, blacksmith, all over the map. And it's fascinating. It's interesting. And again, needed services.
Yeah. Right. Exactly. So. I'm really interested.
Well, we would ask you to contact us. We are bwilliams at number4action.com, or my direct 9 number is 770-973-0878, and we'd be happy to talk to people and, you know, see if we can fit them into a business or coach them and say, don't think it's the right thing for you. Mm-hmm. But, you know, you're better off going out and finding another job.
Yeah.
So we're not afraid to say that.
It's great that you're
with people. Well, you have to be. You know, I mean, I run into my former clients walking through Home Depot, on a weekend. So I want to make sure that I've done everything right and professionally, and I know they're going to be in the community, in the business community. So want to have good relations.
Yeah. We've been speaking with Bill Williams, franchise advisor, consultant, and radio host. Thank you for joining us on GBDNtv and Business Next. I'm Diane Bovino, bringing you.